Kakure Judo Club's three-limb tie-up. So what's going to be happening is I'm going to be stuck kind of in a defensive turtle position. Mike's going to be attacking me from on top. And this is a method of taking control of one hand and essentially using that one sleeve grip to take control of that sleeve, one leg, roll him so that now I'm on top, and then we'll tie up his other arm, and if we'll wind up with both arms and one leg tied up, just using one hand. And it's just kind of a neat thing. It's I kind of play with it. Sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't, but when it works, it's pretty, it's kind of fun. But you'll see what I'm talking about. So, I'm turtled. For whatever reasons, Mike's knocked me down somehow, and he's got me on top, and he's attacking from the top. Defensively, what I like to do is take this far arm and take a grip. Two hands to begin with until I've taken control of it. Basically, I'm just wrapping up his sleeve, taking a strong grip here, posting up, pushing off, and it's kind of just locking him up. I have to be careful not to get myself extended out like this because I will be susceptible to arm locks. But as long as I stay within my base, I'm very difficult to knock over from here, and I kind of own this arm now. As we move around, I'm looking for an opportunity for my arm here to reach through his near leg and to pass this grip in here and to take his arm down through his legs. So here, I'm attacking his forearm, taking a grip. And as we move around, I'm just finding an opportunity to scoop through the near leg, switch hands, and bring his arm in between his own legs. From here, I'm going to reach up and over top of him. You can see he's got nothing to post with on this side now. I'm just going to roll him. Now, I can be happy here and just take this ground hold. I can abandon this arm here if I like, and just work from the top. But if we want to turn this into a little three-hand or three-limb tie-up, my next step would be to come over to this side of his body and pull this tightly up to his chest. The nice thing about this position is that, I'm tying up two limbs. I'm only using one of my own. This arm is exposed. I can step over for a jujigatami. I abandon this and go right into juji. Typically what will happen is he's going to feel that his arm is exposed and he'll tend to want to bring it close into his body, which is probably a good idea under most circumstances. But if he does do this, as soon as I feel his hand get down towards his chest, I'm going to take my bicep, squash it into his tricep, into the back of his arm, and squeeze that down on top of his body. Once I squeeze that down, switch hands again. And as long as I maintain some pressure here, I've got arm, leg, that was the same arm. Arm, leg, and arm tied up with one hand. And it's quite strong. Mike can go ahead and try to push off that as hard as he can. It's quite secure. Now I can look for finishing here. Yeah, I can be just happy if this is a judo tournament. This is osikomi, and I just hold them for his 25 seconds. If it's submission type stuff, I can look for a kitate jime here. Amplify it a little bit by putting my knee in behind his head. Single hand choke. Or this is a striking sort of situation. Just, drop elbows. He has absolutely no defense against any of that kind of thing. So, that's basically how it goes. So I go ahead and take the grip there. Yeah?
Yeah.